good morning everybody. Jimmy with To The Top Crane here. And today is going to be a fun one. Oh my gosh, it's going to suck. I'm doing a cell phone tower today. Actually, we're just doing antenna change outs on it. It's only about 245 feet tall, so that's not terrible. I think we're just going to need two inserts, so we won't have full jib, but it'd be 40 feet shy of having full jib. All right, there's our tower up there on the hill. We gotta go down here. This is a dead end road. We gotta go down here, get out of the dolly, and make our way up the top of that. Really, that doesn't look that steep from this side. I'm here to tell you, it's steep when you're going up it. All right, we got out of the dolly, got through the gate. Now we've got an audience. So I'm gonna put this thing in low side. We're gonna hang a right and go up this hill. Cows probably think that it's feeding time. We're just chugging along in low side and second gear. Already spinning. Time for a little traction control. Okay, so I locked my second axle and I got my diff locked in the rear. Inserts in, well, not all of them, but all of them we brought with us today. So we got two inserts in, so we got 83 feet of jib. I'm pulling my ball up real quick, double check my anti-tube lock. Alright, it's good. So now we're going to cable down a whole bunch, and then we will just scope out. 26,000 pounds of counterweight. I'm going to have all 197 feet of main and then my 83 feet of jib, and hopefully we can reach what we need to reach on this tower. I guess it's going to be pretty sketchy. We're putting new antennas and framework directly underneath the existing antennas and framework, and we were told that the tower was 245. It's in fact 255 feet tall, and their existing antennas stick out a ways. So getting to the backside might be a challenge. Hopefully it works out. Because if I have to put more inserts in, then that means I have to put another slab of counterweight on, which means I have to take this jib off. I get, or at least take the two inserts and the point off, set another slab of counterweight on the deck, put more inserts in, and then put those two inserts and the point back on. Be a couple hours and a pain in the butt. And it's supposed to be 91 today, so we definitely don't want to do that. Hopefully we can reach it. But anyway, we're gonna run some boom out. Before we run boom out, we need to get out of rigging mode. And it's got 83 feet of jib on it. It's actually 82.6. Here goes. And I got a question on one of my old videos. They asked, what boom angle does this like to scope in and out at? And it seems to be happiest between 73 degrees and 76 degrees. I typically shoot for about a 75 degree boom angle when I'm scoping in and out. I need to boom up a little bit. Pretty good view up here though. We're on top of a pretty steep hill, a pretty big hill, and it's steep. I imagine they're gonna have a heck of a view from up there. Gotta love the sun. Jump out and talk to these guys and see what their plan of attack is here. Alright, we're going up with it, so I'm going to go ahead and pan this up. Hopefully my camera keeps recording the whole time. It says that I've got an SD card in it that's a little slow, so that could affect the recording performance, I suppose. Plus side, they do have a really long tagline on it. In a fun spot. Time to have the sun right there. It probably didn't look as bad on camera as what it is sitting here staring into it, but such is the way it goes, I guess. Thank you. pretty easy. I don't know. I can't tell yet. Me into it. I'm staring kind of at the sun. It's hard for me to see where I'm at. My luffing jib, see if that'll help keep us away from the tower a little bit. Swing over, I'm probably going to hit the structure, aren't I?
That's what it's looking like.
Do you want me to come back up with it, swing over, and then lay it down there next to that other antenna? Looks like there I could probably swing left, and then I could maybe luff it back down a little bit. How far below am I, or below those existing antennas am I? Can I keep swinging a little bit?
Yeah, you got probably 70 foot.
Good for him. I give you a little bit more swing left, and then I'm going to lift my jib down right next to that antenna that's closest to my jib. Needs to go away from me a little bit.
Yeah.
About how far? A couple feet? 3, 4, 5 feet?
3, 4 foot.
10-4. So we got that one where it goes. We're pretty close to. They just got a bolt in place, and then we're gonna try to hit the one that's directly opposite of it. We're gonna save the easy one. We're gonna save the easy one for last, which is the one closest to me. So, all right. Well, we'll turn this off for right now. Alright, here's the second one. Get my camera adjusted there.
To confirm, we are going far back away from the grain. Main effector, yes. Got it.
So this one's gonna be even more challenging. Watching this for the first time, that clicking is an indicator on the winch. It lets me know how fast the winch is turning. It lets me know that it's turning at approximately how fast. And also, the guys up top aren't overly good with the radio, so that makes this even more tricky. We'll see how it goes. table up a long ways. I guess I'll pan this up a little bit more. Dealing with a lot of weight, we're just got to be really precise. All right, let me know when I got it high enough. And then I'll start sneaking it over to my right. 8 inches or so, and I think they'll have it. And I think that's what they're doing. Yeah, they got my ball up against that other antenna up top. Probably won't hurt it if they don't put too much pressure against it. They're just gonna pull it over there, put some bolts in it, swing that thing around where it needs to be aimed, and that one will be done. Then we've got one more to put on this side. Should be pretty easy.
Well, we're close to being able to hook it up, but you're fucking touching the antenna on it.
Yeah, I could see the ball was touching that other antenna. I don't know how much further you need to pull it in, but you're probably not putting a whole lot of pressure against it. You're not going to hurt that ball any. I don't know what you'll do to the antenna, but it's not going to hurt that ball. But we got one more to put on this side, and then they've got the ladder.
Fiberglass starting to crack.
Then they got the ladder to hang, which is basically called the ladder. It's just a cable track for the wiring that goes up to the antennas. So we'll do that last, and then we'll start tearing down and getting out of here. So shut this up so we fly the third one up.
Alright.
Going up with the third one.
Man.
We've been here a little while today. When I say a little while, it's after 5 p.m. We started flying these up. After 11. So yeah, it's taken them about 2.5 hours per set to put these on, maybe even 3. Still gotta put the ladder on yet. And again, that's not a ladder for climbing. It's a ladder for attaching their electronic or their cabling to. I got a lot of cabling up to do. Get that knocked out real quick, fast and hurry. Since it is this late, the sun's not in my face anymore. Looks like I may need to boom up a little bit more. right around 1,000. Like if they pull that tag a little bit to the east, that base may line up with your tower. Looks like I maybe need to swing back to the west a little bit. guys are terrible with signaling cranes. Terrible. Absolutely terrible. I'm not going to have a discussion with them over the radio about it, but I'm going to talk to them about it when they get on the ground. Come back on that. I think they got that one about where they want it. In an effort not to just sit here for the next 3 hours with my camera rolling, no, we'll just shut it off. Shut off till we get to the next thing. Alright, we got the antennas on. Now we're going to play a little operation. So they want me to drop. We're putting the ladder up, obviously. That's what I got a hold of. Their antennas stick out past the other antennas just a little bit. So they want me to drop in behind their antennas, but in front of the other one, and get this ladder stuck in there against the side of the tower. Coming down, and then I might have to swing left a little bit. Gonna have to beep that one out. Switch over to luffing, because luffing's a little slower. So we're gonna luff our jib down. Clear of your stuff now?
Yep.
Okay, you guys got to talk me into there. I'm in a real tight spot. And basically, if you could see my cell phone sitting down here in the cab from up there, that's kind of what I'm looking for from down here. So I can't see shit up there.
Gotcha. I honestly don't know if you can come up from the tower.
So, can I swing left at all, or what do we got going on up there?
boom in slightly.
So back towards me?
Yes, sir.
Alright, so we're going to luff it up a little bit. We should have put that on before we put this
lane to your left.
Before we put those antennas up. But hey, we're there now, right? Get my rope up against anything if we can help it. If it gets tore up, this cable is about $12,000 to replace.
We know.
I mean, if you got to pull it over against something to get your bolt started or whatever, that's one thing. I just don't want to be cabling up and down with that rope against something. Just a quick update. Oh, you can see the little light on my camera flashing. Right. It's right there. But I'm not sure if you can see the red light flashing in the tip of the jib, but that is the red light on top of the tower flashing and lighting up the inside of the jib. And the reason why that's doing that is because the sun's going down. Scratch that. The sun has gone down. There's a faint sunset a little bit off on the western horizon. It's because we're almost 14 hours into this deal. But I've been sitting here for better than 2 hours and haven't even moved. On the plus side, when the sun goes down, the air conditioner works a lot better. So much so that I actually had to turn it off because it was getting cold in here. But yeah, I don't know how much longer we're going to be. It could be midnight before we get out of here. It might be tomorrow. I don't know. I probably should have brought a pillow. But anyway, thought I'd give you a quick update. Video wasn't done. Alright, so we're trying to get my rope out of here in the dark. This is fun. Swinging right, nice and easy.
right, right, and come all the way out.
Out of camera mode and take this off a luffing jib. Let's put this on the old Tadano screen. We need to check. change that so we can get to our boom modes. Let the list populate here. And then we are gonna go to boom mode one, which is 43 feet of main. And then stand on the go pedal. And pull back on the left lever and let it retract. And I'm gonna turn the air back on because now it's getting a little muggy in here. Magic inside the boom happened.